हाई स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्यू मीटर। ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो अबाउट क्यू मीटर। इट इज डिफाइंड एज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच मेजर्स सम ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कॉइल्स एंड कैपेसिटर्स इज कॉल्ड एज क्यू मीटर। ओके, इट इज डिफाइंड एज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच मेजर्स some of the electrical properties of coils and capacitors is called as q meter. Q meter depends on a series of resonance circuits. It is depends on the characteristics of a resonant series resonant circuit, that is the voltage drop across the coil or capacitor is equal to the applied voltage times the Q factor of the circuit. Hence we can say that if the circuit is having a fixed voltage, the voltmeter connected across the capacitor is calibrated to indicate the Q value directly. So consider this figure. So this figure is for series resonant circuit. So here XL is the inductive reactance, XC is the capacitive reactance, and I is the current flowing through the circuit. Okay, here not mentioned the I, and E is the applied voltage, and R is the resistance of the coil. And this one is your phasor diagram of the equivalent circuit. Okay, here at the resonance condition XL equal to XC means the reactance of the inductance of inductive reactance is equal to capacitive reactance. So consider this equations XL equal to XC, inductive reactance is equal to capacitive reactance. So then we can write it as, if you multiply I both sides, IXL is equal to IXC, that is equivalent of EC, that is capacitive reactance. So by this we can write E equal to IR. So from this figure we can write the equation as E equal to IR. So where E is the applied voltage, then the Q factor can be written as Q equal to XL by R is equal to XC by R, that is equal to EC by capital E. So from this equation we can say that if we maintain the constant voltage, that is E, then we can find out the voltage across capacitor in terms of Q. And this one is figure for your practical series resonant circuit. Here we have connected the oscillator. To apply the input voltage, here we are connected the oscillator, and its frequency is lies between 50 kHz to 50 MHz. Its frequency is lies between 50 kHz to 50 MHz. And RSH, here the RSH is the shunt resistance, and it is having the low value equal to negligible. Negligible resistance means no resistance. The resistance is typically 0.02 Q here. So here the voltage, that is E, capital E, having low internal resistance. Here the voltage across RSH is calculated by voltmeter, that is indicated by the multiply Q by meter. Next, at the output side, the voltage drop across capacitor, tuning capacitor, that is resonating capacitor, is measured by the voltmeter. So that is mentioned as EC, that is the voltage across the tuning capacitor or resonating capacitor. The scale of this voltmeter is in terms of Q values directly. So in this circuit, to get the measurement of any unknown components, those can be connected to this testing terminals. Means this CD is one of the unknown component. So that are connected between these testing terminals, means at this node and this node, we connect the unknown components here. And the circuit is adjusted to resonance using any one of the two methods. Those two methods are, first one, by setting the frequency of oscillator to a certain given value and adjusting the tuning capacitor. Here we have to adjust the oscillator frequency value as well as tuning capacitor. That is one method. Second method is by presetting the capacitor to a required value and varying the frequency of oscillator. By presetting of this capacitor to a required value and by varying the frequency of oscillator. That one is the second method. So at the output side, the Q value will be multiplied by the index of the setting of the multiply by Q by meter to get the actual value of Q. So at the output side, the Q value is called as the circuit Q, since it includes the loss of voltmeter, tuning capacitor and insertion resistor. So here the effective Q value of the measured coil will be higher than indicated Q or circuit Q. This difference is very small, but and it is neglected also. Then we can find the inductance value at the resonance condition. So that is XL equal to XC. So from this, so XL equal to XC, that is, we can write it as, so XL is equal to 2 pi FL, that is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. So therefore we can write it as L equal to 1 by 2 pi F whole square into C, and the units are Henry here. So in this way we can find out the inductance of the coil. So these are your Q meter and then inductance value. Okay. Thank you.